In this video, I want to explore the new automatic region chaining for our 2D toolpaths in Mastercam 2022. Let's look at programming this printer cartridge mold assembly. For this demo, we're going to focus on the lower mold base. Let's isolate that component to get a better look at some of the machining that needs to occur. View sheets are being used in this file, and I can click on the second one called Mold Base. Right-click in the graphics screen and set the view to top. Let's focus on these green, blue, and orange surfaces, which are all great candidates for the control and efficiency offered by Mastercam's 2D dynamic toolpaths. Let's work from the top down and start by machining both green pockets. From the Toolpath tab, launch a dynamic toolpath in the 2D gallery. There are a bunch of enhancements to chaining, but the first and arguably the most impressive is this new automatic regions. I'll circle back to that in a minute. For now, I'll chain this utilizing existing methods. First, selecting a machining region, use an outer loop selection method and pick both green pockets. Click OK. Turn on preview chains. The system thinks that I have specified an internal pocket here. Though this will work, it will be more efficient and better on the tool to machine this pocket from the outside instead of trying to helix down to depth. To do this, I will select that outer open edge as an air region. Select outer open and pick the same two faces. Performing another preview, you'll see that the algorithm now properly understands the geometry. This works well, but let's explore the new automatic regions. Shut off preview chains and delete all the current selections. Click the automatic region selection arrow and Mastercam will automatically default to face selection. Click the green faces. The automatic selection wants to gain as much information as possible about the face. Notice that it is also chaining the holes. Checking the results with preview chains, automatic regions produce the same result, but with only two clicks. No manually defined air regions necessary. Click OK to end chaining, select the 20mm end mill on the tool tab, and then create the toolpath. Automatic region chaining made those open pockets look easy. Let's try it on these blue closed pockets at the bottom of the part. Launch another dynamic operation, use automatic regions, and select the two blue surfaces. Click OK to end chaining. Since these pockets are smaller and more intricate, use the 10mm bull end mill. Leaving all other parameters alone, I'm going to click OK and let the toolpath generate. As we've seen, automatic regions works really well for very simple open and closed pockets, but let's put it to the test in a more complex scenario. This orange surface has two bosses that will need to be avoided, as well as two distinct air regions at the shared edge of these blue pockets. I can easily do this through conventional chaining methods, but it would certainly be a lot more mouse miles, and I would need to be very proficient in 2D chaining. Instead, create another 2D dynamic operation and select automatic regions. One click on the orange face and click OK. Using preview chains, it's evident that with one click, I was able to create the toolpath that I want. It automatically avoids the bosses and it sees all other areas properly defined as air. There have been impressive improvements to the intelligence of the 2D chaining in recent releases of Mastercam. New selection methods like outer shared, outer open edges, or bosses make things easier, but it still does not offer the ease or automation seen here. I'll close chaining and again use the 10mm end mill. Leaving everything else at the defaults, click OK to generate the toolpath. The result is a great toolpath that took very little effort or understanding of chaining to create. Mastercam is taking care of everything and making dynamic motion technology more accessible to a new or beginner user. Now I'd like to show you what is happening in the background. To do that, I can copy the last toolpath down. Launch the toolpath geometry on the copied operation. Click the selection arrow and automatic region chaining to launch the chaining manager, then expand the solid chain. Here you will see that Mastercam 2022 has a new chain type, automatic region face. The great thing about this is that it is completely associative. If any changes occur to that face, whether done with model prep or any other means, the toolpath will automatically associate an update. So what do these new automatic region faces consist of? And what if this new automated process is not yielding what I had envisioned? There are a few options. Close the chaining manager. In the automatic region chaining selection, there is a green arrow, Convert Automatic Regions. This will populate the chaining into standard chains. Now we have standard machining, avoidance, and air chains. If we look at the preview chains display, you will notice that there is nothing different from the auto region faces previously selected. However, these are fully editable chains just like previous releases. For example, launch air regions and delete the second chain. Click OK and relaunch preview chains. You will notice that the one air region is no longer active. Click OK and generate the toolpath. In this video, I exclusively covered dynamic mill, but dynamic contour, peel, and area mill all benefit from this technology. This is the biggest enhancement to Mastercam 2D chaining in many releases, but it's not the only one. In another video, we'll continue programming this mold base and talk about some of the other region chaining enhancements. If you found this video informative, I'd encourage you to check out that one.